Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, you're now under the sounds of the voice of your brother Kahan Tazadaq, an aggrieved man, aboriginal, national. I wanted to talk to you today about maxims of law, contract law, and color law. Typically, maxims of law, because you're dealing with these color law courts. Now, the information I'm about to provide you with is actually just for that, information or entertainment and educational purpose only. It is not to be taken as legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel and please be advised. So, what are maxims, you say, Tazadaq? Well, maxims are actually brief statements of self-evident truths. So, maxims of common law explain essentially what's fair and what's right, and therefore what is just. What is just? Justice. So, maxims are self-evident truths that actually supposedly control the courts. But these color law courts are no longer seen to be controlled by maxims. It's supposed to control our legislators and every consideration of mankind that seek what's fair, what's just, and what's best for all. Justice. So, courts that do not honor or consider these maxims are unjust courts and color of law court. Now, they appear to be law, but they're not law. So, whether and to what extent these common law maxims are actually honored by these public venues known as courts and these public leaders is how we actually test the way they administer the law to govern us, because they're supposed to be governed by these maxims of law. So we, the people, are actually protected by the fundamental principles of justice and fair dealing set forth in these simple statements that actually every school child should be taught to practice for the sake of peace. Now, this is why it's important to know maxims of law. So when you go into these courts, you'll know when you're being violated. Common law is actually built on these truths that actually promote the spirit and practices of fair dealing and the unbiased administration of justice. So without the legal enforcement of these truths, there can really be no true justice or right dealings between us. This is why it is essential for people like Tazadaq Sahibay to stand up and articulate these truths to the people and all the others out there that's doing this work. So, you know, there is, you know, hope of getting these courts to do what's right by enforcing our contracts, because it's always about the contract. Contract is law, and law is contract. So enforcing our contracts are making those who injured us pay damages. Contract, contract. Every day that we live, it is governed by contract, law. It is governed by law. It's governed by contract. Wait, the contract is the law. So these courts are actually established primarily to enforce these principles of common law. But you have certain people that actually has been placed in office and they want to ignore the common law. So it is the responsibility of we, the people, to ensure that the common law is being applied. It is the common law that's common to all. So this is a law that actually never changes and never should be changed by legislation or by the arbitrary rule of tyrants or any kind of tyrannical system or a tyrant motivated by what's good for the interests of a favored few, because that's what's been going on. Now, you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. There's a selected few that's dictating everyone. So this is the law that all for one and one for all should be enforced. This should be the American way, but unfortunately, it's not that way. So the common law expressed by these maxims is for the common good. So it is, after all, the common good that is the heartbeat of justice, and supposed to be the heartbeat of America, and I find that very trivial. So the simplest saying of common law maxims evolved over many centuries as man and woman of goodwill struggled against the hateful tyranny of these monarchies and parasites to establish governments dictated to protect man and woman from the abuse of those who would actually use the law to their own private ends. And this is what's going on in many of these color of law courts today. So with the advent of printing presses, people were better able to communicate across the political boundaries, and there began to develop an increasing general awareness that governments had duties to the governed. You must understand that, folks. You have to hold these people to their duties, and in their public servant capacity, they have to be held to their duties. So entrance of individuals needed to protect and be protected is the reason that we elect government officials in office. So partiality towards persons with power needed to be removed if they're violating the authority that's given to them by the people. So law to protect the common welfare need again to be established, not only in the form of so-called philosophies, but in the very offices of governments that seem to have become de factos, where the force of military might has been sealed and seated. So gradually, over a period of many centuries, brothers and sisters, and at the expense of many lives and private fortunes, government power was required to submit to the common law of the people, i.e. the people's law. You had a show called The People's Court. Well, in the people's court, it don't seem to be dictated by the people. You have a bench trial going on this show they entitled The People's Court. So this video, brothers and sisters, is about that particular law, the common law, simple law, self-evident law, principles we all should embrace and teach our children. Now, I know many of you don't agree with this. You think you don't need this. But every day that you live, your life is affected by contracts. And since it is, you need to understand the law. I mean, the contract. Wait, the contract is the law, and the law is the contract. It's always about the contract. So, for example, one maxim states, a thing similar is not exactly the same. Now, who could disagree with that? It's self-evident, as are all maxims. Another maxim states, water does not run uphill of its own accord, nor should courts believe otherwise. See, these statements set essential limits on truths and are essential to fair and efficient administration of justice according to the common law of mankind. Do you understand? So no right thinking man or woman can disagree with a maxim if you're in your right mind state. Now, if your mind has actually been manipulated and the de facto has you discombobulated, then you may not agree with the maxims. So every court is actually bound by the common law rules of equity established by never-changing maxims. Fact, fact, fact. If not, it's a color of law court. It's a color of law court. Maxims are among the self-evident truth that Thomas Jefferson mentioned in his Declaration of Independence. Maxims are the liberty or the light of liberty's lamp. Many of us are not given that liberty. Maxim tests those who judge in their black robes and put an absolute limit on those who rule. That's why these maxims need to be memorized and known or kept readily available. So everyone knew the maxims of common law. If everyone knew the maxims of common law, should I say, then our world would be far better. It would be a far better place to live. Because these maxims of common law is based on what? The laws of the Creator. Maxims are our common law heritage. So their truths bind us together as a people. Now, here's the hope of happiness for future generations will survive. For here are the bedrock truths upon which we can all agree and by which we can actually secure ourselves and our prosperity, the blessings of liberty and justice for all. How do you do that, Tazadaq? Enforcing the laws of the Creator. You use these maxims to get your way in court and to demand your legislators and other officers of government to do what is right. You use these maxims. Maxims are the truths on which justice must forever stand to lift her precious lamp. Let the light of the maxims shine. Now, what's the primary principles of common law? It's supposed to be liberty to all, but preference to none. So, this maxim, and it's a maxim, by the way, this maxim explains that liberty belongs to each of us equally. So, according to this, are you not equal in the law with the black robe? Yes, you are. So what authority does he have over you? None. You grant him authority by referring to him as the judge. Hey, Bob, are we not equal under the law? I'm talking to the black robe. As stated in the Declaration of Independence, we each have God-given rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But none has more of these rights than any other. Do you understand? The black robe don't have any more rights than you. In fact, he may not even have had jurisdiction over you. You showed up with a general appearance and gave them validity. So the Heavenly Father gives to each by the same measure. There is no preference to any. This belongs to, and being so, these courts are obligated to protect our liberties accordingly. So each of us is entitled to equal treatment under the law. This is a maxim. None is entitled to any privilege denied to others. Absolutely none. Do you understand? So this maxim is the soul of the Republic of America legal heritage, for it was in America the concept was actually first given its fullest recognition. Islam? Shalom. So none has a greater claim to live free than here. So no king, no priest, no celebrity, no judge, not any person has any greater right to walk free than any lowly so-called carpenter, plumber, or law-abiding street thug. Do you understand? We are all equal in the sight of law. So, none is entitled to any privilege denied to others. Absolutely none. Absolutely none. So is the black robe entitled to any privilege that you're not entitled to? Absolutely not. We are all equal in the sight of the law, in the sight of the true law. So Now, of course, if we violate the obligations and responsibility that arise from the privileges, then the law provides that we may lose our liberties. Understand that. So don't reach out to me if you intentionally cause harm to others, if you create mischief in a contract, or if you damage someone's property because you've actually you've broken the law. So if we murder, according to the Bible, if we lie, according to the Bible, if we steal, according to the Bible, we are in violation of the law. What law? The common law. The law of the Heavenly Father, which is common to us all. And the law has a remedy. See, these courts can take away your liberty. See, if you refuse to love your neighbor as yourself, what am I teaching you? I'm teaching you the common law that HaMashiach Yahawashah taught, Yeshua taught, the one that you refer to as Christ taught. It's common to us all. When you violate this law, you're in violation of the law. You see, this system of law is based upon that law, these maxims of the laws of the Heavenly Father. Do you understand? So when you refuse to love your neighbor as yourself, the law can limit your liberties or even take your life if the crime is sufficient and outrageous. You say, Tazadaq, that's a wicked law. No. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, and a life for a life. That's the law of the Heavenly Father, of the Creator. So long as we obey the law, we are at liberty to love, to live, and to laugh and enjoy all the benefits life has to offer any living soul, regardless of your heritage, regardless of your financial circumstances or your political advantage. Do you understand? So the right to liberty does not grant a right to take away what others have. Do you understand? You can't go and take my property. The right to liberty does not grant a right to demand material wealth. The right to liberty is a power to do with our own lives what we so ever choose to do, using whatever we have at hand to accomplish our goals. So as long it does not infringe upon the right of others, or it does not give us the right to take from others. It does not give us the right to lie about others. It does not give us the right to limit the liberty of others just because we do not like their opinion or the way that they dress or their skin color or the things that they say. Hey, you may not like the Ku Klux Klan, but they have a right to stand on their soapbox and speak as they so will. That is their right. You may not like the Black Panthers. They have a right to stand on their soapbox and exercise their freedom of speech. That is their right. The right to liberty is the right to obey the laws, and while obeying the laws, to live free from influences by the state or others. And what has happened? That the state, the de facto, has begun to put statutes, codes, regulations, acts, and color of laws in place that restrict the liberty of many. See, liberty is a great right, not privilege. They've made it a privilege. So the obligations and responsibility that go with liberties are also great. So we in this nation risk losing our liberty because we too often are willing to fight for the liberties of others and too quick to grant special privileges. Do you understand? So we share an obligation and responsibility to protect our neighbors from the exercise of unlawful powers. Justice for all, privilege for none. This is all I do. I don't have any intent to overthrow any kind of government or anything of that nature. I am exercising my obligation and responsibility to protect the right of my neighbor from unlawful powers, from color law systems. Do you understand? Do you understand? So the safety of the people is the supreme law. That's the next maxim. The safety of the people is the supreme law. I'm going to say that again because many of you black rolls and attorneys at law just don't get that. And you constables on patrol or you policemen, policemen. So the safety of the people is the supreme law. One problem society faces is not knowing how to judge their laws. What is the principle? How do we recognize good laws as good and bad laws as bad? See, the maxims give us an answer. Man's laws must submit to higher laws. What are the higher laws? The laws of the Creator, the laws of the Torah, the laws of the Bible. Any law that fails to promote the safety and well-being of a people is a bad law. Now you got laws stop and frisk. Then you end up beating the hell out of someone or shooting them down in the street. You got laws, which are not really laws, where you pull people over and you search their private property without a warrant, without probable cause, and you may end up killing the people. I'm talking to you constables on patrol now. So for example, suppose your state passed a law that authorized a particular company to transport dangerous substance in flimsy containers, and as a result, people were actually injured. Now such a law does not promote the safety of the people, according to this maxim of law. Such a law would be illegal pursuant to the supreme law. So since good law promotes the people's safety, any law that fails to promote the safety of the people is an illegitimate exercise of state power. I need you people to understand that. And matter of fact, I need you to watch this video 10 times so it could be embedded into your subconscious mind. Now I want you to think about this maxim that I just recited, and then I want you to ask yourself, is these statues that they're promoting for these policemen and the way that they're killing people in the street and calling it justifiable homicide, does that promote the safety of the people? That's the question. And if not, these are bad statues that they're referring to as law. The people's safety come first. The prosperity of any particular industry, individual, or minority subculture within society is never more important than the safety of all people, and any law that promotes the prosperity of a single industry, individual, or subgroup within society to the detriment of the people themselves is illegal because it violates the supreme law that people's safety come first. Now, with that being stated, I want to ask you a question. Why does the media and these police departments emphasize it so much when a policeman's life is taken? It seems like their lives are considered to be more important to the average everyday citizen. But not according to maxims of law. You signed up for the job. You know the risk that comes with it. And the way that you're treating people in the street, could very well be a case of the chickens coming home to roost. Now, I'm not talking to all of you. Just 99.9% of you need to get right. Because you're being taught this. And I'm going to tell people one thing. Do not trust the police because anything you say will be used against you. It can and will be used. And remember this, no matter how much you trust the police, they have been trained to never trust you. Understand that. Understand that. And I'm just working the people up. So too many private interest groups, political action committees, and lobbyists succeed in getting their legislators to enact laws that favor a few but are bad for the people in general. Can I get an amen? So the proponents of these laws argue that their private interests deserve a break, or that the selected few are somehow more important than the many. See, these arguments violate the maxim. Laws these people seek to enact are illegal because the people's safety is the supreme law. You must understand that, folks. And the very moment that you believe this, the system will begin to change. Next maxim I want to talk about is the safety of the people cannot be judged but by safety of every individual. I'm going to say it again. The safety of the people cannot be judged but by the safety of every individual. So this maxim teaches us where individuals' right comes from. Since the safety of the people is a supreme law, this maxim tells us how to judge the safety of the people. It's not just the safety of a majority that counts. Oh, that's so-and-so. This is a political figure. It is the safety of every single one of us individually. So if a law is bad for an innocent individual, then it's bad for all. Now suppose your state passed a law making it a crime to have so-called black skin, which is really essentially brown, or to have gray eyes. Brown-eyed people are in the majority, about 3-1. So the majority could conceivably pass a law making it unlawful to have gray eyes. Now, some scientific evidence might prove that gray-eyed people are more likely to commit crime. So brown-eyed folks could condemn gray-eyed people to death. After all, majority rules, or does it? See, that is a democracy. Mob rule. What the majority want goes into effect, but that is not the way it's supposed to be. And this is why they've been preaching for democracy, 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 democracy. See, in civilized societies where maxims are upheld, the majority is prevented by the principles of maxims from wounding the minorities. Maxims teach us that every individual must be safe or society itself is not safe. So this principle promotes minorities from the majority. And this truth, brothers and sisters, needs to be taught to every generation. They protect us all from abuse of the law that always resorts where such truths are hidden from the people. And this is what's happening to many of you in these color law courts. This is what's happening. So the maxim teaches that only by evaluating the safety of every individual can we gauge the safety of society itself. It's good to support legislation to protect so-called minority groups and individuals from being invidiously discriminated against by society's laws. But until we use our maximum power, we are merely fighting political battles. Do you understand? Do you understand? So politics alone cannot make the world safe for individuals. The need of individuals and so-called minorities must be protected, not only for the sake of individuals and so-called minorities, and I'm talking to you so-called blacks and Hispanics, but for the sake of society in general. So this self-evident truth is expressed by this maxim. The safety of society cannot be judged but by the safety of every individual. Now, how safe is a society when you have policemen going out murdering so-called blacks like it's fair game and calling it justifiable homicide? Just something for you to meditate on. And now it's come to the point that skin color is beginning to matter very little. So you so-called whites had better watch out, because now they're starting to go after you as well. And if you deny it, just look at what's going on. So the safety of society cannot be judged by the safety of every individual. If anyone, however insignificant he or she may seem, is being unfairly wounded by our laws, then the laws are wrong and should be repealed at once. And this is what's going on with a lot of these constables on patrol and so-called black people being murdered in the street. And now, many others, the police departments are just starting to outright violate the rights of these people. So the powers of maxims outweigh the imperatives of the majority. So if any law unfairly wounds just one innocent man or woman, the law violates this maxim. Do you understand? And the law should be changed. And with that, I'm going to bring this one to a close. And I trust that you gained something from this video. And I trust that you will begin to study maxims of law and make sure just laws are in place, and any unjust law that's in place, that we the people will move to strike that law or extract that law with a proper law. So if you found the information in this video to be of value, please click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find this information to be worth. $200, $100, $50, $20, $10, $1. Or if you need some direction or you need some personal coaching, click the email link below the video. Just look down, it's below the video, and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. If you would like to take yourself from out under the system and you would like to become a secured party creditor, undergo the redemption process, and click the email link below, and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. And with that, I'm going to say shalom. I'm going to say Islam to the Moors. I'm going to say peace and blessings to you all, from the United States to the UK. Brothers and sisters, fight the good fight. You can no longer allow a small selected few control and dominate the people. It is time to teach right knowledge, and it is time to ensure that proper law is actually being enforced. So until next time, Tazadaq Shabbat and Shalom.